Good morning, Gethin and Sam. Oh, gosh, you know what I've just noticed? How dark it is this morning.
Yeah.
All of a sudden,
that change comes through,
doesn't it?
Yeah. It's trying to come through, the sun, isn't it? Just over that.
Missing our sunrise over Manchester. Mm. Yeah. Packed show for you coming up on Morning Live today. Right now, thousands of people are living with mould in their homes. Earlier this week, Dr. Zand explained how damaging it can be to your health.
Yeah, it comes after the heartbreaking story of mould. There are calls for a crackdown to tackle the issue. Today, Matt Allwright is here to tell you your renter's rights.
Yes, I'll be telling you what a good idea.
Also today, with 9 out of 10 NHS dental practices not taking on any new patients, many are resorting to DIY dentistry. We find out...
Plus, they can improve the chances of surviving a cardiac arrest by up to 70%. But turns out only 15% of us would be confident using one in an emergency.
And Amanda Holden will be here to tell us why being a celeb... Paddy McGuinness in a completely different way.
That would be a different kind of show, wouldn't it? Maybe they need that next.
I can hear your voice. Of course you can.
We'll see you later.
Thank you very much.
Live.
Thank you both. Doctor of the Year, eh?
I know. Doctor, brilliant. Brilliant.
Doctor of the Year on BBC Breakfast this morning. We love you, though, Ranch.
Thank you. At least someone does.
Coming up on Morning Live this morning, following the heartbreaking story of a 2-year-old who died after being exposed to mould in his home. Matt Allwright is here too. Thousands of renters living with it.
Plus, with 9 in 10 NHS dental practices not taking on any new patients, we find out...
...investigator for the hit Saturday night game show, I Can See Your Voice. Hello, welcome to Morning Live on a Thursday. As you were seeing on Breakfast this morning, Royal Mail, teachers in Scotland and some university away from air travel.
This completely applies to me, especially carrying baby milk, water, all sorts... because the restrictions on hand luggage, liquids and laptops will be axed, hopefully, in 2 years' time, thanks to 3D scanners.
Such a shame it's in 2 years' time.
Necking all that water before you go through school.
Security is it's a lot, isn't it? Can you
imagine behind them in a concert, not seeing anything with that hat.
That's so true.
Ranj, we're also doing something which is really close to my heart. You're talking about defibrillators today.
Yeah, they're becoming more and more common.
But we'll put all those together at the end of the show.
Yeah.
Thank you, Katie.
Yeah, we're going to be exhausted. But first, there's been a fresh round of industrial action announced by the RMT union. Workers...
I think Do you know, I was chatting to Julie and Megan for Christmas, because we've been through COVID for 3 years, with lots of people not being able to sit, and she can't go because of the trains. It's like she's 24 hours working.
Yeah, so many different situations. And Hannah said, the only way I can go and see my aunt is by train. So all the strikes have really affected our relationship. There's no way she can drive this far and see me.
And visiting family.
Yeah, and Denise says, I have to take my daughter to a hospital appointment in London the day before the first strike and have booked to return at 7 p.m. It's just adding more stress to all.
Yes,
in their rental properties. Matt, you're here to tell us what our rights are.
Yeah, absolutely.
Welcome.
Oh my goodness, there's nothing worse than dental pain, is there? It's horrible. I'm not sure Riyadh really enjoyed the whole tooth and the bag thing from that lady, you know.
I don't know if I'm a bit... I would quite like to have seen it.
Would you?
Weird that way.
You are a bit weird like that.
I find it fascinating.
You would... I mean, it's true that Jimmy Carr does get carried away on the show quite a bit. Good morning, Amanda.
Morning.
Lovely to see you.
Hello. And you. How are you both?
Very well, thank you. Yeah. Excited about Series 2, then. You're coming back for more.
Oh, yes. We are, yeah, it's already been back. I'm excited.
Yeah.
Actually,
I think some web pages say that I was actually on blind date, so maybe this is a good time to tell everyone I wasn't, and I didn't get chosen, and I wasn't number three. But that's another story.
I was on blind date. I was number two, and I didn't get chosen.
And who have you got on, and what can we expect?
And
yeah, I mean, it must be brilliant. I was going to ask you, to be honest, I mean, why do you love being a celebrity investigator? But like you say, it just sounds so much fun.
It's so much funny.
Our children in the studio watch it too. Matt Allwright and Dr. Ranch love to dance along to the test now, because it's a lovely moment with Clear when you're doing the 5, 6, 7, 8 routine. Let's have a look. Take it away, boys. Yeah. That's the thing, though. You do.
I feel like maybe you should have a. Sorry, there's a delay. I can't hear you. Go on.
No, you go on.
I was going to say, do you have Keep Fit on your show? Because I thought Claire could be like the new green goddess, couldn't she?
Don't you worry. We've got Katie McGlynn, bit of Strictly Fitness at the end of the show. Amanda, are you actually on air now? Are you in a song on air? It looks like Christmas has come early where you are.
Oh, my goodness. So on...
It's begun.
For it. Yeah. we've got to ask you as well, Amanda. You've got a new project with Alan Carr. Tell us a little bit about that.
Oh, my goodness. So in lockdown, Alan and I came up with an idea. We taste lots of olive oil. We make our own tiles and shutters. We bash walls.
That sounds good.
Judging by that picture, you look like the modern-day Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah, indeed, yeah. And we all know...
You got
two very, very special cars in your life. One we'll see in January. Of course, the other one you can see on a Saturday night. I play it. Love to see you, Amanda. Happy Christmas. Lovely. You're warmed up for that now, Ranj.
You've done
your steps routine.
I've been doing my stretches as well.
With a stretch camera. Perfect. Going to put you to work right now. We're talking about defibrillators.
Yes.
And this is something that you know quite a bit about, unfortunately.
Yeah, it wasn't until I went on a first aid course that I didn't realise that you could... Well, you needed a defibrillator to potentially bring someone back to life. And my husband and I, after the Euros last year, when Ericsson, who played for Denmark, went down, it kind of gave us a bit of a shock, really, and we thought it doesn't matter what age you are, what background, that it could happen to anyone. So we decided to purchase one. I had a conversation with my mum where her local one was, because again, she didn't realise how to use one or where it was. So,
and your neighbours can use it if they had to.
So we bought one after last year and decided to print a little letter to everyone, our local community, and tell them that they could use it if they needed, and gave them a number.
And that's the thing, Ranj, that they are so important. They are literally life or death.
Yeah. So AEDs, so they have lots of uses. They can be really, really helpful. It's really important, though, to differentiate what we... So you don't use a defibrillator in the event of a heart attack unless you go into cardiac arrest, but...
OK, let's get stuck into the defibrillator then. Should we bust a few myths? Mm. OK, first one, you need to be trained to use a defibrillator.
This is one of the best... Use them.
All right. And obviously, you're talking about the difference between a heart attack and a cardiac arrest. What about if you... Can you still shock someone who has been misdiagnosed?
Yeah, those, do the they work will for not you? Deliver a shock. Right. They take the thought out for you. You don't it's have to be thinking.
It? All right.
Okay. And what about defibrillators can electrocute you if they're used in a wet condition?
This is always a worry. Ideally, if someone is so important, regardless of whether you've got a defibrillator, doing those chest compressions is vital.
Okay, so this is an interesting stat. A defibrillator can improve the chances of surviving a cardiac arrest by up to 70%, but only 15% of us would know how to use one in an emergency. Is it possible to talk us through?
Yeah.
Do you have enough time to do that?
Absolutely. I'm going to do that now as quickly as I can. So if you see someone that collapses on here, as advised, plug it in. Comes with that. You can only plug it in the right way as well. By the way, there we go. I'm going to turn that off for a second. Now, you continue CPR until either an ambulance arrived or, obviously, the patient comes right.
I was going to say, because if you're on your own doing this,
is
there a point where you should stop or know when to stop?
You keep the patient comes around or help arrives and takes over.
I can't believe how straightforward it is. You can see why people are put off because it's such a scary thing to do. But the machine does the work for you.
Well, this is the best thing about it.
The training one, isn't it? So we've not taken one out of circulation for today.
No, we haven't. This is a specific training one. They are becoming more and more common in various different places, public places, workspaces, and it's been installed, which is fantastic.
Well, it's similar when we posted the letters. A lot of our neighbours got in touch and said, well, that's fantastic, thank you, but we're willing to donate. So it's a nice idea as well, but maybe some of your neighbours or housing association club together.
And, where do you find them?
It's really important, I think, that if you've got a nearest defibrillator, it's really important. You do that.
Mm. We'll check those websites on our website. As always, we update it throughout the day, so be patient. They will be there for you for any advice on what Ranj was talking about there. Thanks, Ranj.
Yeah, perfect. So easy.
Easy as that. Yeah. Is don't be scared. Mm.
Now then, wildlife expert Anne Brummer has dedicated her life to rescuing animals, from badgers to swans. She's helped plenty of creatures, all great and small.
We're looking back to when she fostered two deer, Monty and Amber. These little cuties are guaranteed to make your heart grow fonder. So cute, but can we please just talk about poor Lizzie, the older sister?
Where's she been?
Where's she?
I know. She probably stayed in the bottom bathroom. Maybe that's where she was. Yeah. I like their son going to school saying, your son's got a vivid imagination. You've got swans and badgers in the bath. And mum goes, no, we do. We generally do have them in there. That was lovely, wasn't it?
Cute.
Such a lovely moment when they're released to the wild. Now then, we absolutely love seeing your life hacks. We've been doing this for the past couple of weeks. We've been asking you to send in your life hacks. We want to hear your best tips now for Christmas decorating, from how you save money on decorations to maybe how you untangle lights. That's always a bit of a faff, isn't it?
Yeah.
Maybe how you put the fairy on the tree. These top tips that we need.
Yes, please send them in. Please film yourself telling us about it or even doing it in landscape, so that way, with your phone or your camera. Send your clips to morninglive@bbc.co.uk or just drop us an email and we'll be back in touch with you to help with the filming of it.
Look forward to receiving those. All right, time for a bit of a dance to finish our week, actually, of course. Strictly Fitness with Katie. Cue the music.
Good.
It's a reminder then, Katie, a refresher.
So, a reminder, refresher. So, we've got our arm flaps. So, we're going to go 1, 2. Ooh. You can add a little step if you want to do that.
I think I'm into the step.
Yeah, Sam, you do. Lovely.
I got it.
And then the next move is kicks and flicks. Now, for this one, I literally want you to kick, try and kick your glue if you can. And the flick, if you want to do it, is a little flick at the same
time. What am I doing, Katie?
Sam, what I want you to do is the flick. And do your legs as well if you can.
Yeah, I can't.
Yeah?
My glutes, my bum. I can't
yeah, you can't really get your glutes on there. So make sure you do your arms. And then we have got our punches and kicks. So we're going to go 1, 2. Oh.
Hang on. This is a bit fast yesterday.
I've slowed it down.
Okay,
I've slowed it down. So the punches, Sam, I want you to be doing your punches. Four punches for each side. And then add your leg in at the same time.
That's obviously still the same pace.
That's too complicated for you guys. Just do the punches.
Okay.
I'll go one on.
Okay. Yeah. Take it away, Alan.
With an energising workout.
Let's go for it. Last one of the week.
Katie McGlynn.
Ready? Let's go. Flap.
Oh.
Flap. Now, kick. There you go. Kick. And add your flick if you want to. Punches. Punch. Punch. And punch. Punch. Punch.
Hard to change, though, right?
Oh, to each side.
Punch. We're halfway, guys.
Punch! And we're gonna go back to the flap today.
That's a flap away weekend. Thank you for watching this week. We'll be back on Monday. Have a lovely weekend.
Bye.
Bye for now. Bye, everyone. Stay safe. Bye.